So if we're using the Insert Citation tab on the Microsoft Word plugin in order to take our citations from Mendeley and put it into our narrative, when we use that option, they're not necessarily going to be configured to the specific format we need in the context that we're working with. As an example, when we use a long citation and a short citation, the formatting isn't going to be 100% correct. So we're going to have to go in and manipulate the citation just a little bit in order to get it to be perfectly formatted the way we want. So here, as an example, I have a long citation and a short citation. I have the citations highlighted in red. Now, once again, in my writing, this wouldn't be there, but I've just highlighted it to draw your attention to it for this particular example. So here, for the long citation, we'll work with that one first. We want to cite the Stanley Brooker and Gilbert article. So all I would do was come in here, make sure my cursor is where I want it to be. I would click Insert Citation. I would search for the Stanley Brooker and Gilbert paper. So I'll just click on it, put it into the editor, and click OK. And then here's how it comes up. Now you know the citation is connected to Mendeley because it's highlighted. So there's just a little bit of detail work we need to do in order to get it formatted properly. So the first thing we're going to do is just click on here and delete the open parenthesis. We want to delete the comma. We want to change the ampersand to the word and. And we can add an open parenthesis. And then we can add a colon. And we can delete the red. And now we have a perfectly formatted long citation. So let's take a look at the short citation now. It's going to be just a little bit different. We want to cite the Wolf 1997 article. So we'll do the same thing. We'll put our cursor where it needs to be. We'll click Insert. We'll search for the Wolf article. Here it is. We'll click on it, get it into the editor, click OK. Now keep in mind that this popped up and we've seen this before, the Keep Citation Edit. Because we've manipulated the automatically generated citation, it's going to ask us, and it's always going to ask us, whether or not we want to keep what we did in terms of the editing. So in this particular instance, we will. So we'll click Keep Manual Edit. Now we'll come in here, and you notice that we just have to add some page numbers. So we'll click inside the citation, put a comma, and it's that simple. We'll delete this, put the period. And we're good to go. So now we have perfectly cited formats for both the long citation and the short citation. So now just to double check and make sure that the changes that we made within the in-text citations don't have any bearing on changes in the citations that we're going to generate within the bibliography, let's take a look. I'm just going to insert a break to the next page. And then this can be our reference section. I'm going to click on Insert Bibliography. It's going to ask us once again if we want to keep the manual edit from before, so we'll click Keep Manual Edit. And the citations come up perfectly. So now once again, if we just want to edit these, just to sort of reiterate how to go through that, we can change the font, change it to Times New Roman. We'll go to Format, Paragraph. We'll change the spacing to double. We'll get rid of the DOI information. And we have perfectly formatted citations as well. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. If you did, make sure to give us a big thumbs up and like the video. If you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking the link above, and make sure to check out some of our other videos. We'll see you again soon.